crosses upon Citadel. Curses upon Citadel. May you rot on all.
Claimed he is the chosen one. cartographer of histories, myth behind the mask, fit for the Moaz cast. He is the cosmic lightning warrior. Powered by ultraviolet sun.
Here's what the shorts don't understand. I don't have shit to lose. I've never owned property. I've never had more than $2,000 in my bank account. I don't have some fancy job that I'm afraid that I'll get fired from. I've never had shit, and I won't ever have shit until these stocks squeeze. So I'm not selling until the stocks are at stupidly high numbers or the companies go bankrupt. And the companies are not going bankrupt, at least not anytime in the near future, okay? So I'm not afraid of shit. I come from the bottom. I'm still at the bottom. The only way that I'm gonna get out of the bottom is by these stocks squeezing. So you can make it short in all you want. You can fail to locate all you want. You can fail to deliver all you want. Still gonna be here, even if it takes 10 years. Why? Because this is probably my only shot at making financial freedom for myself. And I can speak for most of the apes when I say that. We don't have shit, that's why we're not afraid. Do not fuck with us. And I can speak for most of the apes when I say that. We don't have shit, that's why we're not afraid. Do not fuck with us.
Is let it rip.
We're gonna be fucking rich.
That's it. That's fucking it. I got nothing else to fucking say. Plain and fucking simple.
Nobody's selling this thing, man.
We're gonna be fucking rich.
Nobody's selling this thing, man. Nobody's selling this thing. All right, brother. Hey, have a beautiful night. I will see you soon.
Love you, brother. Peace out.
You know who I'm talking about, Mr. Griffin. Let me tell you something. There's only one Kenny G, and it ain't you. Okay? Remember that. Now, let's do something fun. Let's have some sax from the studio.
It's Tuesday, December 21st, and this is an update for AMC. I'm going to be doing fractal analysis today and focusing on just a couple areas of the chart. So, first of all, I know that there have been a lot of folks that have tracked this cycle, so-called cycle, that believe that we're repeating time frames. And I adhered to that for a little while, believing that we were in May, for a time and tracking those fractals and things seemed to track one to one up until about November 24th when suddenly it deviated and it seemed like we were no longer tracking the same thing. Ever since that time, I really devoted myself to just focusing on the fractal sequence. And for those that don't know, this fractal sequence can be broken down into three basic parts. There's a T1, which typically looks like a volcano. There's a T2, which looks like a larger mountain right here, followed by a little head and shoulder. And then there's the T3, and the T3 is basically just a cup and a half. Now I know these views are a little bit obscured here, doing some other things with my fib, and I didn't hide it from my chart, but you see this is the cup, and this is the half. And in this case, it just seemed like it just didn't break out, right? When we were back in November, this was November 8th, actually, arguably could have been a turning point. After this point, the fractals no longer seem to track very well. And I think part of the reason that a lot of us were gravitating towards that is because it's easier. It's easier to think that if it's mimicking or imitating a certain time frame, it's easier to make predictions, to follow along, and to then make educated guesses about where it's going to go. And I do think that there is a sort of a cycle on this stock, but I think it's more of a repetition of how the sequence plays out between accumulation zones and distribution zones. Accumulation zones, distribution zones, and how it enters those zones and then how it exits those zones, right? Enters and then exits. And I think that, well, I guess exits still to be here, right? And then again, enters, exits. And I think that that's probably the best way to look at this. And then you also have to look on the macro, the large time frame, and say, okay, well, if I think that this is the way that the stock's being traded, then I should apply it to the larger time frame, look at, you know, these larger moves, and also make estimations about what's happening and where it may be going. And that's the approach that I've taken for about the past month now. That's the reason that I got into the practice study, just noticing the sequence and then noticing how it's playing out on the macro. I say all of that because today I'm going to be looking at a few different spots on this chart, and that's going to frustrate people because it's going to present options, right? And that this stock may or may not do certain things. And I've been very bullish. You know, I insisted that this right here was a T-test and that we were going to break out. I didn't see much downside. A lot of people were calling to come all the way back down to like 21 or even 19. And I was very bullish. I said, you know, I don't think we're gonna get below 2250, right? And we did. We barely dropped that morning, and we ended up running. I've talked a lot about the sequence in this region. It's been pretty one-to-one for the most part. You know, on the micro, on the daily, there's just not much you can do. I mean, until you see the larger fractal that's being formed, you're making educated guesses about micro movements, which honestly, like, don't move the stock that much, right? I mean, we may move up and down a few percent every day, but you know, if you're not scalping, you're not day trading, you know, you're not, don't really matter. Ultimately, what matters is the larger sequence at play. And so my belief for a while has been, yes, we are in this sort of terminal spring action. We had this major sell-off, and it was to bring back the liquidity to the stock. And also that, yes, we are currently in a spring that followed the T3, this cup of tea. And so, when looking at that, it's been pretty easy to look at certain regions, such as the breakout in, you know, January, and then also the breakout in June, because these both occurred after or as a result of some kind of a T3 pattern. But truth be told, finding out quote unquote where we are in this pattern has not been the easiest thing in the world. And I've made an effort to track it insofar as I can by using the August fractal, which is this one right here. And the reason that I use this fractal, and the reason I like this fractal, is because it's easy to see and understand, to me anyways. I see this head and shoulder pattern. I can see the way that it moves fairly clearly. I don't see everything, but I can see a lot of things with this fractal because it's spread out. So this is kind of the one I've been using. And as we've worked our way up, my general feeling about where we are currently is that in the sequence, we're setting up the T3. And the past couple of days has given me some time to reflect about what it is that really goes on in the T3 and why it's significant.
I want to get paid. Take a chill. Get laid. In other words, relax to the max from dusk to dawn. Out in the backyard and cut the lawn. It ain't hard to try to stay alive. I'ma chill and take five.
And we've talked a lot about this R1 over the past few days. And it's really, to put it very simply, it's exiting this particular liquidity zone, exiting this accumulation zone, if you want to call it that, and starting up the run where you eventually get to distribution.
Take five.
Hey, this is Gasparino, the gas man, and I got a message for all you apes out there. Talk to my lawyer, because my lawyer's gonna be in touch with you. Lou, not for nothing, but you're full of pineapple pizza FTDs, synthetic naked shorts, you transmethodite unicorn communist snowflake. What you got?
Not only do they gotta buy the shares back from us, okay, cancel that one out, that's phase one.
Alright, phase one. Now what the fuck do you think is phase two, huh? You smart ass motherfucker from Brooklyn or wherever the fuck.
The fact that there were so many failure to deliver on our side, meaning I gotcha, you have no fucking idea.
Who do you think is running this show?
Lombada. That's the Lombada. And comes every day with this fucking yellow hoodie. Let me tell you something. That motherfucker come over here, I'm fucking putting him to sleep.
Lou, you are an ape. Say it with me. You are an ape.
The amount of shares they have to buy just to give them to us in order for us to be able to sell to complete that cycle.
What cycle? Because all I see is a fucking motherfucking transmethodite, unicorn communist, pineapple pizza eating, not for nothing loving homo.
Now you gotta understand, when this cycle does start.
What cycle?
Give them to us for us to sell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
They don't exist.
They created this fucking weird circle.
Who are you talking to here?
That at the end of the day is gonna drive this thing to a level that nobody's seen. And I keep explaining this and I don't know. Do I need a fucking board?
Yes, you need
a
fucking
pigeon over there and take two squirrels and move it over?
Half a pigeon and half a squirrel.
They fucking sold us invisible synthetic. I got you.
I need half a duck.
You're gonna press sell, buy them, give them to you, take them back and throw them over to the exchange.
You're an ape.
If somebody could tell me how that's gonna happen considering there's no shares out there, I will be happy.
You look, you just say I am an ape.
Putting his ass against a fucking tree.
No. You don't have to rub your ass against a tree. Just say I am an ape.
That was adopted by white parents.
Alright, you were adopted by white parents, but say I am an ape. Just say it.
Let me tell you something.
Let me tell you something. You are an ape, Lou. Not for nothing, but you are an ape.
Over here, I'm fucking.
No, I'm not gonna come over there. I'm just telling you, you are an ape.
Bam.
You need to deal with it, alright? You know.
So, one day we're gonna get them. That's what's gonna cause this to be the fucking 10x factor. When you guys message me on that, I understand you guys don't understand.
No, you don't understand.
These free broker apps.
I got you.
And then they gave it to us. Didn't give it anything to us.
It's easy. All you have to do is say, I am an ape.
And then the little D's that were shorting, they were borrowing to short from us, but they weren't borrowing anything. It was like invisible fucking nothing. Now you're understanding the world of AMC and GameStop. Now you're understanding why this thing is gonna be catastrophic.
Is that a cat?
A lot of money to be made, but.
Did you kidnap Luna? Did you kidnap Luna?
Yeah, I got Luna somewhere. Do you think this is fucking Santa Claus Make-A-Wish Foundation? Like, fucking for real. We're dealing with motherfuckers on the other side, and you're worried about you and Christmas? Go fucking hug a tree or something.
Look, I'm putting you on the naughty list. That's fucking bullshit, Lou. Naughty.
I can't, man. These motherfuckers can't.
No, I can't. Love you. Big hugs. Go fuck your mother. Not for nothing, though.
And I got another one over here with four fucking dogs walking around with like six leashes.
You should never leave your home. Stay inside.
This is supposed to be. By the way, you motherfucker, why do I go to the park?
Yeah, why do you go
it's
to the park?
It's part of my physical rehab. I'm supposed to be outside. It helps me with my vertical and all that other shit. You get punched in the head a couple of times. All the other side bets they were doing on this, like the shit that Goldman's involved in. Let me tell you something. This is bizarro world. Because they've taken these fucking synthetics and packaged them and sold them off to other unsuspecting motherfuckers, and they did it, and they did it, and they did it, and they did it. Woo, sweet baby Jesus.
Yeah, but it's just, they're doing the job.
Hey Lou, you're a motherfucking transmephidite, half a Kojak, son of a duck, cursed crypto mental patient on libertarian leave. Are you a duck or an ape? Did the devil put his foot up your ass?
What?
Come on, man.
The reality is, it's not really the case. When the devil took that action, they've done everything to kind of like undermine us.
What you know, are you, a transmephidite now?
Some
what are you, 100% transmephidite?
Like,
who are you calling an asshole?
I'm not employable.
Who are you calling an asshole?
If I was, their work hours wouldn't work with me, and I'll probably get fired after the first. I'll be that motherfucker. Go to human resources now, motherfucker.
You know, that's what I told you
yeah.
about time.
But when they look at the other side, if they see a fragmented force,
go
then
fuck
they
your
think
mother.
They still have a chance to fuck with us.
Go fuck your mother.
You understand?
Yeah,
you
fuck
don't
off.
Like me, trust me. Chances are, if I miss some of you motherfuckers,
I'm hanging up now.
Motherfuckers will be done.
I'm hanging up now.
He's coming.
What are you, a victim?
You're
a victim?
Guys, while we're all in the
I'm not a victim.
We don't want to. Everybody has to.
I don't need the same
together.
Thing.
And understand the attacks back and forth that are going on and
hey,
all
that's,
this crazy.
That's your duck.
Whatever.
Go kiss your
you
duck.
You have to understand.
Hey, Lou, let me just ask you this one question. What do you think it's going to show if I tell you to go fuck your mother, I love you, giant hugs? What's that going
to
do?
That's going to show a force to not only the little D's, but their investors and the street.
Is this a squeeze?
Now it's time for us to accept the fact that we dominated.
I want a duck. Lou versus Wall Street likes Wall Street.
You better like it, Wall Street, as well.
Oh, we like it. We like it a lot.
In it? Of course there is.
It's fucked up.
It's normal.
It's all fucked
well,
up.
What isn't fucked up?
But relax.
Relax. It's all normal.
That's how I'm looking at it. Right
it's
now,
it's all fucked up. And
we got, what, we're at 30?
Normal.
Love you, motherfuckers. I'm still around.
All right.
Just explain something.
All right. Shut the fuck up. I fucking love you.
Love you, motherfuckers.
All right. Let me tell you something, Lou. Let me tell you something.
Coffee!
We are going to get through this. And
coffee!
I know no one's selling cheap after what we've been
doing. I'm not selling cheap.
And the money is there. So.
What money?
Love you, motherfuckers. That's not for me. You know what? I got it. Just look at this motherfucker.
Low, low, low.
Just look. You see that? That's the kind of motherfuckers in my neighborhood.
Low, I've been looking all over New York City.
This fucking neighborhood?
Manhattan for you.
You got the wild motherfuckers coming around.
And I just wanted you to know that
no joke.
I want you to see my new pet squirrel. Its name is Popcorn.
This fucking squirrel. This
yeah,
dumb little motherfucker
is...
showing up here. Dude, I ain't got no food for you and that crazy chick is around here.
Its name is Popcorn.
He comes over to me and all of a sudden there's problems.
Well,
I know Popcorn dumped a bunch of shares.
I like the squirrel, but I have to tell you that I had an accident.
Anyway.
And it's very bad and I can't find my shoes, shares, or glasses.
At the end of the day, just be calm on it. Our play is still in.
And I sent a helicopter to come pick you up.
No joke.
But they said they were busy.
No joke.
So they might show up later. I don't know, but I fell down the stairs and my brain hurt.
Talking about felony level stuff here. You might as well walk away.
Oh, I know. It's very complicated these days, but I'm telling you that I'm worried about my AMC shares, and I think I broke my head.
No joke.
And my shoes fell off because my cat Luna took them.
Think about how confused that little motherfucker's gonna be. That's New York now, and this motherfucker. Anyway.
Yeah, well, I'm very worried that your duck is not a duck, it's a goose, silly Willy.
Don't trust motherfuckers like that. Here's my thing. Holidays are coming up. DOJ stepped in. Across the board.
Okay.
Obviously, this is some wildness. So,
wild.
I know
no.
a lot of people are a little nervous on the price dropping.
All right, tell me.
This is going to go on for a couple of days. Remember when I said,
Lulu...
Going back, I didn't care if this goes down to $3, $6.
Luna.
It doesn't really matter.
But Lulu, are you gonna probe me? I mean, I really don't, I'm not into that kind of thing. I know that you're slightly half a fag, and I told you before that I like your bald head a lot, Luna. But I just
nice
can't go there with you. Although I'm willing to share some AMC shares. Now, are you gonna sue me and use an anal probe? Because if so, then who's the victim in that case?
Let me tell you something. If this play fails, we're gonna start selling the drugs that motherfucker's on.
Are you my manager for this event? Is this the squeeze?
Anyway, once this moves forward, then this probe
yes.
investigation possible indictments.
I know.
It's not just AMC or GameStop. This
Popcorn.
Is across. This is across a lot
Popcorn,
of fucking things.
Get back here.
You know who's gonna get nabbed? Who's not gonna get nabbed? Who's gonna
Leave
get pulled?
The
who's gonna
alone.
Get liquidated? Whatever. It doesn't matter.
Lou thinks
this era of what they've been doing is gonna come to an end.
Lou,
a lot
Lou.
Of things. That video I did last night with the Evergrande.
I can't see
that's
you.
Still current. There's still a,
you
know,
you
a wildness coming because
oh, no.
this was all done on mass leveraging and all that's going to be all
I
that's going to be coming to an end. But I want to tell you people,
so I
being
have glass.
Friday,
Lulu, I have glass
now,
in my feet.
Take it easy. Get into your weekend.
Okay.
Calm down.
I'll try to calm
whatever
down.
You're seeing, it's just your truck passing by.
But
whatever you're seeing in the numbers
there's
or
a
the,
truck?
The lines and whatever, that doesn't mean anything anymore.
I can't see
right
shit.
Right now, all eyes on
I
the
can't
street
see anything.
What's going on is going into this probe because, obviously, the research firm, the short sellers.
Okay. All right.
This is a big change for everybody.
My brain hurts.
So I wouldn't expect us to be in normality by getting back online with this play, at least for a couple of days. Just
chair.
Because, I mean, everybody's
Lulu
tied to
them.
This type of stuff one way or another. So,
Lulu took
you know,
Luna.
Be cautious with the videos that you're watching or reading and stuff like that. Because, like I said from the beginning, there was too many nefarious characters in this.
I'm not nefarious.
And I think by
I
now,
just, I need
people
help.
Have to fucking own up to the fact that when I said this was going to be a managed event,
uh-huh.
I think there's no more doubting what the fuck I said.
Well,
okay?
I
back
just
then,
worried.
I saw there was no possible way of this
Are
was
you my
to
manager?
That level. So we're here now, okay?
Okay.
And uh-huh. they're looking at this across the board. Whether they're looking at
Lou's
AMC
looking.
Directly.
I can't see a damn thing, Lou.
Or GameStop Lou. Directly.
Lulu.
Let me tell you something.
Luna.
These two things are so large.
Popcorn, get back here.
That they're going to have to be set aside and they're going to have to be managed directly.
The squeeze
so
is not the
that's
squeeze.
That's why I say right
I,
now,
I know. This,
be
this,
calm.
This,
there's nothing to go crazy about. Everybody's
sure?
freaking out. And,
because I'm
you know,
very worried.
The helicopter's not for me.
Oh, that,
we fucking cool. It was
finally,
cool.
Yeah, they're finally
run,
showing
motherfucker,
up.
Run.
I can't run. My,
you know, it's funny.
My feet are all cut up.
The helicopter is definitely not for me.
Well,
their plan is not to vaporize retail. We are the new money on the street. So I think you people understand that. And eventually, you know something?
Yes.
You motherfuckers are gonna have to
don't talk to Popcorn that way.
My tweet over
I don't like
to
it,
my
Lulu. Lulu,
where
I,
do you
know,
think this probe
Lulu,
started from?
You know I don't like
this
it when you talk to Popcorn that
this thing
way.
Started, you know, where.
So, even the silly Willy Goose.
Just checking.
You use cuss words and very hurtful
anyway,
language.
Over the next couple of days, you'll see craziness.
I just
its
wanted,
first run-up was in end of January, January 22nd, kind of like that. So we're still within the one-year marker.
Okay.
But here we are. So
I'm worried.
Just be calm,
I'm
be cool,
very
everything.
Worried
eventually,
about
all
and,
matters will
and
be
our
settled.
Shares, our AMC
and
shares.
Here we are. So while we're doing this video,
I can't find them.
There are people that are actually doing things. So
Luna,
just be calm with it, and just like I said,
I think Luna stole
sexy
the shares.
The weekend. We'll have some laughs.
I'm
promise
not
you
as
the
sexy as
tonight
you.
With the ice story, some other stuff,
thank
and we'll
you.
Take it easy and we'll move forward.
God bless you, Lou. God
there's
bless
gonna be
you.
There's going to coming.
Lou,
news coming.
Lou.
Okay.
God,
this girl comes back. Dog. I don't got a Snickers bar.
You can. We can have peanuts.
Fucking guy. Anyway, giant love, motherfucker.
Giant love.
Back.
Bye.
Going back to the fucking, the never-ending loop. Don't worry, I got you later. Well, guess what? One day, we're going to get them. If you need to grow your position, of course. But
Luna.
Thinking that we're going to push this on our own? No more. Trust me. How many shares have we bought? What are we in the 30s? Come on. If you really believe at the end of the day that this thing is doing what it's supposed to be, no. When we all start going through this nonsense and we're looking at the price and the little bees start covering and these momos, the brokers, have to start fulfilling their obligations and the devil starts to process those orders that have been parked, you're gonna see wild price valuations happening because what they're doing is they're turning around and all the fuckery that they did for such a long time is gonna start going to the market like in wild fucking waves. So trust me when I tell you, we're gonna have a period where you're gonna be like, whoa, why this motherfucker just ripping? Because there's gonna be shit going on behind the scenes
that you have no idea what's going on. So I'm telling you, when this comes down, that's why the report, the FinTech, the Orta has nothing to do with anything. We're living in a crazy world, and once they start doing this crazy stuff, you'll see the price jumps. Because just think about it this way, little D's, big D's, and brokers all scrambling for shares that don't exist. And everybody like, you're not taking these motherfuckers. I want everything. Because you will never mistreat me again. Motherfuckers, the price jumps when this shit starts ripping. Sweet baby Jesus. Love you, motherfuckers.
I'm behind you.
Did you ever hear from Ghost Trey? He was a mod that was nice to me, but I never found out if you heard back from him. He went missing. He left, man. He left. He never came back. I don't know any more than that, unfortunately. Drogo, I feel like you're on the sun with us, man. This is terrifying as fuck. Give me a sign, pussy.
One more.
Show me something. Let me think of a hiding spot in here. You're ugly. You're fat. Whoa, did it just drop something? Did you see that? Get a picture of my body. Get a picture of my dead body.
That's not
me. Go get me.
Go take a picture of Trey's body now.
Go get my body.
That was freaky.
You gotta go. You gotta go. Do it. Do
it. Is that your body over there?
No. I'm in there a ways. I'm down that fucking door. You gotta go in a ways. Go. Go.
I don't know if that's a razor. Okay.
That's not me. That's not me. That's not my body. Get out. That's me. That's me. That's me. Take a picture. Take a picture. That's me. That's me. Take a picture of it. Take a picture. That's me. That's me. Take a picture. This way. That way.
Man, run.
Go this way.
Human sacrifice. Dogs and cats.
Go this way.
Together. Passes carrier.
Enough. I get the point.
Yes.
Oh,
you can do it. You can do it. It's right here. It's right here. In and out. In and out. In and out. In and out. Because I'm pretty convinced it's not Ghost Orbs. I'm gonna check one more time.
You go get a court order, and I'll sue your ass for wrongful prosecution.
You can have it your way, Mr. Edmund.
Drogo, I feel like you're on the sun with us, man. This is terrifying as fuck. I don't want to even go in there, because I know the second I step inside, I'm dead. Radio's on somewhere. You hear that?
Hello, baby.
Behind me.
Let's go. I'm behind you.
Oh, ah! Fuck it!
No, don't bite my leg. Stop! 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 You're a terrorist. God, you're an asshole. Isn't that right, you little dick? Hey, you're mean. You're a mean little asshole. What a lucky boy. I used to have nightmares about two things. I've talked about this briefly on stream before. One of the nightmares that I had was about Chucky, that doll that would kill people. And the other one was about Chuck E. Cheese. Coincidentally, they were both Chucky. The nightmares that I have with Chuck E. Cheese, it would be the same nightmare every single time I'd have had it. I would walk down into a dark alley on a street, and there'd be a garbage can in the middle of the alley. And what would happen is I'd walk in there by myself into this alley, and Chuck E. Cheese, the fucking super old, like early 2000s mascot rat, would slowly creep his head up outside of the trash can. And I'd see nothing but his eyes, a little bit of his head, and his mouth. And he'd just stare at me for a little while. And then his head would pop back down into the trash can, like one of those old-fashioned, like, metal bin trash cans, like the super big ones, the bulky ones. And I'd walk back to the trash can, I'd keep walking towards it, keep walking towards it, his head would pop up again, and he'd grab me, They'd drag me into the trash can and they'd rape me. And I had that dream when I was like 9 years old. It was fucking wild. All right, let's ready up. Let's do this shit. We have literally fucking everything. Wow.
I hate this.
Yeah, I've been stocking up.
All right, guys, let's do this shit. Let's do this shit. Let's do this shit.
Oh, hell yeah. Ba-da-da-da-da.
Ba-da-da-da-da-da. Nobody's gonna die. I'm gonna say half a minute, but I promise.
Demon's gonna find you. Ba-da-da-da, maybe. Ba-da, maybe, maybe not. Ba-da-da-da, probably.
I got the moves.
Shadow?
Something strange
in your neighborhood.
Who could it be? My cat! If he bites your knees and he touches your balls, who are you gonna call?
Alright, Shadow, let's do this shit. If Trey dies, you have to take off his shirt. What the fuck is up with that, Uncle Mike? There was one time when I went to Uncle Mike's room, and he was just getting out of bed, and he was butt-ass naked. I've never seen his dong hanging from his fucking stomach. He had an elephant trunk. I was not prepared for that. That was a scarring day. Nobody wants to see their uncle's wiener.
Yo! Yo, what's up, guys and gals? What are we doing? Has anybody lost their minds yet today? Congratulations, folks. You've made it. We are going to be rolling into Sunday here in an hour or so. So happy Saturday night, Sunday, if you're watching this. And then look at this beautiful picture we got right here. The legend himself, Mr. DFV Roaring Kitty sighting out there. Now, this has been blasted all over hell, this picture, like it's a sighting of Tupac, which is just absolutely outstanding. I've seen the awards over on the Superstock page, like 2,800 awards. They even have a GameStop a logo next to him with the red and black GameStop logo. And, of course, he's got red or black on, too. You savages. I say this a lot, you guys.
You savages.
Fine. And just, it's amazing. All of the correlations to things. The Brian Cohen tweets. The DD. The everything. This is... been a lot of fun. It's going to be great when the squeeze finally happens here, whatever time frame that is. This is something we will never forget, because this is a monster, stressful, huge deal, not only money-wise, future-wise, but the whole market is going to be changed because of basically this guy sitting right here, this handsome fellow. He had lovely locks on. So that's outstanding. But anyway, shout out to GameStop Due Diligence. Who else is going to tweet that out, right? GMEDD. The whole market is going to be changed.
Yo, what's going on, you crazy savages? What is everyone doing on this fine evening, morning, wherever you're at? The new year has begun. Feels a little bit different, like a fresh, clean slate. I don't know why I think that. It's probably the stupidest thing I've ever said. Never mind, I probably said a lot more stupid than that. Anyway, we're about to fire this thing off. Or if you're tuning in the morning, let's see where these stocks
will go to this week. We have some key names coming up with FTDs.
GME, AMC, especially GME piling to the moon with the FTDs and the ETFs on the threshold list and blah, 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 blah. Let's see what comes of that. This whole Fintel thing's driving me up the wall. I seen our boy Trace Trades over there in a small pissin' match with Fintel, and then a crazy-ass tweet.
And just, it's amazing. All of them.
Back to you guys. I always tried to figure out a contest. I'll do some more if this one ends up being pretty cool. I always want to give back too. I think it's super fun. So that'll be cool to do. So if you haven't done it, just subscribe, fire yourself over here, follow me here. That way I can grab all the followers and then put them into the randomizer, and I random them off Monday night or Tuesday, and it will be recorded
and it'll be done on random.org, so there's no bleepery going on there, right?
Now, this is the craziest thing.
You guys remember Dr. Susan Trimbath? She was on the Superstock. Very knowledgeable woman. I'm sure you guys have seen a lot of that older stuff that she did. But anyway.
This is the craziest thing I've ever seen. This is the craziest thing I've ever seen.
Upon being blocked for years, my whistleblower choice
is
arrested or dead. Long story short, you click on this, it brings it over to this article here. It's kind of hard to follow this. This is very interesting to me. Follow this. Last night, I spent 2.4 hours being handcuffed after battering rams hit my door. Police and FBI called out my last name, and automatic rifles with spotlights were shined upon me. This is what I get after blowing whistle. Lovely. Doing lovely. That's it, you guys. We're out of here. Remember, blast yourself over to my stupid old Twitter mobile here and just follow me here, subscribe, and then we're going to random off a few gift cards on Monday night. That'll be fun. So that's it, you guys. I am out of here. We are one day in the book. Not much to talk about. I'm going to try to find some more stuff. But this thing, this whole thing is crazy to me. I don't even know what the hell to think about this. I'm going to do some more reading. I'm sure you guys will. I'm sure you guys will comment on what else you guys know as well, too. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Rest. 2 more days to go, and we're good to go. Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.
GameStop and AMC. This is inevitable. I can tell you 100%, if these two stocks get fucked over, all of Wall Street gets fucked over. How do we win this? If the line is bullshit or the information is bullshit, basically everything is in bullshit and they can do whatever they want to move forward. Here's the thing on this. The government is preparing for that, and it's one of the reasons why they're reshaping everything. But in the process of preparing for that and reshaping how things are going to be handled in that world, where now in the new digital asset world, in one fucking month, they could just go bananas. What they're doing to prepare for that, let me tell you something. All those new capital requirements, all those new rules that they're all putting in place, all the changeups that's coming, is going to make us inevitable. I mean, you have to understand something. We are the last disaster of an era of security manipulation. GameStop and AMC, the market can't go forward until it fixes it. It's facing another era of craziness. So, to tell you what we need to do to win, it's not us that has to do it, it's already happening. That's a nightmare, that, and I think a lot of people just look at it as like, oh, X amount of billion synthetics. No, you're not looking at the fact that all that shit was packaged and resold and packaged and resold. So at the end of the day, this nightmare is bigger than the line. It's a catastrophe. That's why you look at the CNBC and the Fox or whatever. They're not talking about the real deal. That's how you know they're fucking, they're all compromising bullshit. They're talking only about the stock. This stock. Why doesn't anybody just turn around and go, hey, listen, where are all these fucking synthetics being packaged? Where have they been sold? Like, what the fuck? Like, this is everywhere. How fucking toxic is it? And this ain't the only toxic shit that's been repackaged and sold. The market is facing the day of days. Like, it's happening. And there's so many other, like, catastrophic bubbles that are going alongside of us. I mean, we got the fucking real estate. That's going fucking down. We got the fucking student loan and college dormitory loan crisis drama. That shit's going down as well. That's bigger than 2008 subprime. So you add that, the meme stock. You add also, we've had this unbelievable amount of over-leveraging on so many plays outside of the meme stock. It's just like, their funds that are 100%, like everything they were doing was fucking margin. Look at Anchorage. Poof. If anybody would have taken a look at how their sheet was done, it's like, what the fuck is this? You show up with a dollar, I give you a thousand? That doesn't even make any fucking sense, but that's what a fund is now. Catastrophic events are all around us. Everything has to be settled. And that's why we're going into this new era, and that's why the new rules are there. We have to be addressed because in many ways, it's almost like a change of the guard. Like, I see myself now saying in the future, like, okay, stocks. The traditional format of is a stock, you know, company issue stocks, and you know, we could buy into them, everything. But the second they put the options chains and a market maker could do multiple freaking, you know, I gotcha, and then the broker does I gotcha. What's the difference between that and the unstable crypto world? Because at the end of the day, I don't know, stocks are looking more unstable than crypto. So anyway, what do we have to do? Right now, we are not doing anything. They have to address this because the nightmare, it's across the board and it's real. They've been fucking around in other plays, manipulating that and crypto, because they can make a line move. No joke, they got the money to make a line move. But the thing is, that is the reason why they're changing the capital requirements. And they're gonna strangle these motherfuckers. That's why the SEC is looking to do fines higher than have ever been hit in the street. And the street knows this. Right now, everything is changing. The opportunity for wealth in this stuff, while we've been holding, and it might be, oh my God, it's horrible. But like I told you, this is part of the game. You know, if you were in Bitcoin when it was 7,000, by the time it got to 60,000, that was about a year's time. The manipulation, the bullshit, the paid-off motherfuckers, the bots, the tubers, the fucking, the news analysts, all these fucking things. But at the end of the day, move all that shit aside. They have created so many synthetic shares on this thing that two corporations in America don't even know what the fuck is going on. That's why they have to fix this, because the integrity of fucking Wall Street, the integrity of Wall Street, the sanctity of it, what the fuck is the sense of fucking going public? Why? The street can manipulate you to death and cost you hundreds of millions of dollars and at the end of the day bury you. Now, these hedge funds have gotten out of control. The government and the SEC, you can see that they're in the process of doing this. But you have to understand something. This was a monster that got out of control and kept going out of control through different fucking administrations. But we're here now. This is it. We've hit the wall. This stuff has to be addressed and cleaned up and moved forward. Because what's to stop retail to abandoning Wall Street and start going to different crypto exchanges and making fucking a coin today, make 100,000 tomorrow, sell off. It's going to get planet wacko very soon. That's why they're changing everything. This is inevitable. I can tell you 100%. If these two stocks get fucked over, all of Wall Street gets fucked over. And the chain reaction over and over again, let me tell you something, it's going to be deadly. So, love you motherfuckers, good morning, and I'll probably do a live stream in a few minutes. So, giant hug, motherfuckers.
All the stock in America is owned by a corporation no one's ever heard of called CD & Company. And not just warehoused, not just guarded. Literally the ownership is in this company. And then that company has issued what are basically chits or IOUs into the DTCCC that propagate out into the system of brokers and this and that. And all you really own, if you actually read all the terms upside down, backwards, and Greek, and on page 8, your brokerage agreement, what you will understand is you actually just have an IOU from a company, which has an IOU from another company, which has an IOU from another company, which has an IOU from a company in New Jersey called CD Corporation that actually owns, legally owns, corporate America. What could possibly go wrong? But basically, think of it this way. We laugh at the Soviet Union trying to run society without property rights. But who here owns any stock in any publicly traded company? Everyone with your hand up. Who owns any stock? All the stock in America is owned by a company you've never heard of called CD. You're going to have to stop if I back up. This system was invented in 1973. Until 1973, stock. There were guys running around Wall Street with sacks, they were called runners, sacks of stock. They ran among the brokerage houses, okay, you had a client that sold 1,000, they did this. They got behind starting in the 1960s, it's called the paperwork crisis, Wall Street paperwork crisis. Got so by the early 70s, Wall Street was only open 4 hours, 4 days a week,
5 hours a day or something, because the guys on the bicycles couldn't keep up with the volume. So the SEC and the industry got together and created a new system that said, okay, all the stock is going to get moved into this corporation you've never heard of called the DTCC. And all that's going to trade are entitlements, share IOUs against that stock. So there's about 400 brokers who have, and if you read your brokerage statement carefully, you'll discover that that fine print nobody reads, it's in there. And then there's another few thousand brokerages who have relations with those 400. So if you think you own stock, if you're in one of those brokerages, what you really have is a contractual right to your broker, who has a contractual right to another broker, who has a contractual right to the DTCC, who has a contractual right against this company called CD, who actually has the property rights. And my theory that I started putting together 10 or 11 years ago is these daisy chains of property rights, like these daisy chains of contractual rights, turn out to have much more slop in them than you would ever imagine. Slop was designed into the system such that it wouldn't vapor lock. They were allowed to be loophole, allowed to be different, so it wouldn't vapor lock if there's a mistake. What happened was the bad guys, by the late 90s, organized crime, figured out how to use that stock slop in the market to manipulate prices, to create markets. Just to give you an idea, one of those loopholes, option market making exemption, what these mean technically, you can capture and learn about this somewhere. It's called the Madoff exemption, because a guy named Bernie Madoff, when he was the chairman of the SEC, the chairman of NASDAQ, went and got the SEC to put one of these loopholes in there, and it turns out to be big enough. So what started happening by about 15 years ago, and it's incontrovertible, was that slop let people start selling, let the system start selling. If you have an account with, let's say, Merrill Lynch, and you think you have 100 shares of something in it, it may be that they have 100 shares and they're telling 5 different people you own it, that each of them, they're saying you own it. So this problem underlies so many of the scandals that you've heard about in the last 6 years. It happened in the stock market, which is called making short selling. But philosophically, the same problem was a big part of the mortgage-backed security crisis. Turns out, so your 08 crisis there, they would sell a mortgage-backed security, which just means they take 1,000 mortgages and stuff it into a sausage, sell that mortgage-backed security. But as the lawyers would do the paperwork to get ready, and that day to sell it, they might not have had all 1,000 mortgages. What they would do is they would put in some IOUs and say, well, we'll catch up with the paperwork later and later and later. Well, the American Banking Association, when all this turned over in 08, they came out and said somewhere between 18 and 30% of the stuff in these securities doesn't actually exist, which is why you may have heard about these weird banking cases in Florida where the guys who owned the bond were showing up in court trying to foreclose on some homes. There'd be the foreclosure hearing, and 3 different groups would show up thinking they owned more than the bonds. That's the backstory. That's what was going on. It went on, if you remember, it was the MF Global, the brokers that melted down $2 billion in securities got hypothecated and rehypothecated to London, and there was a cash arbitrage scheme, and no one could tell anymore who really owned it. U.S. Treasury instruments are rehypothecated on average 3 times, which means for every actual U.S. Treasury bond, there's 3 to 4 insurance companies and pension funds who think they own it. On most days, none of this makes a difference, but when the system comes under stress, it's going to make a big difference.
So this is like the plot of the Mel Brooks movie, where they oversold the production. and it's good as long as the production, you don't act like pay off.
You're not just another pretty face, Cleveland.
I like it. I'm not even that.